Hey guys, Becky here with Design Bundles, and I'm super excited to have you join me today for another fabulous Cricut tutorial. Today, we are cutting faux leather, also known as leatherette, earrings.
All right, guys, so here we are in Cricut Design Space. This is just a completely blank canvas, and I'm going to go to my upload button right here, go to upload image, and browse. And then, of course, in my downloads, I have an awesome earring bundle that I downloaded from Design Bundles. And these are for Valentine's Day, so I love them even more. Now, if you want to get a preview of what each one looks like without any special add-ons or anything like that, you can come to the PNG. Okay, and the one that I'm going to start with is I want number 6. And then the other one that I want is going to be, we will do number 25. So no modifications needed. This is an SVG format. So therefore you don't have to worry about anything like that. And what I wanna show you, I'm gonna import both of these. One we're gonna leave as is, and then one we're going to modify a little bit. And the reason that is because what I want to show you is a basic teardrop earring. Okay, so we're going to go to, we're going to ungroup. So the reason I'm ungrouping, let's hit the pause button real quick. If you look over here on 25 that's selected, you'll see I have the circle, which is for the hole for my J-wire earrings. And then you have the earring itself. So I have to ungroup those before I can make any changes. So I am just going to select the earring. I'm going to go to contour and I'm going to hide that contour. Okay, so all I want is the earring and the hole. And the reason that I do that, let's go ahead and group those back together. The reason I do that is because I just want the teardrop shape. I feel like the teardrop shape is perfect for beginners, and it's a really great way to capture if you're working with pattern leatherette like I am today. So pattern leatherette looks really good with solid earrings. And let's do one more set. I did a copy and a paste. And I'm going to ungroup, and I'm gonna hide everything except my circle. Okay, I want that circle because what I'm going to do is I'm going to also make myself some little triangle dangle earrings, okay? They're just, it's another, just a basic shape, but I want you to see how cute these are working with the patterns, okay? So just some little, we'll do them. Here, I'll come up here to the size. We'll do 3/4 thick and 3 inches high. There we go. And we can just position that hole on there. And this is how you're going to make your own. Anytime you are trying to set up your own, I like to use a hole that is already part of an earring set that I have because I feel like it's already sized correctly. I'm going to go to a range. Just kidding. I'm going to go to a line. And align center horizontally, and then I can go ahead and group those together. As a matter of fact, if I want to, I can hit slice, and that will take the hole out for me. And I can do the same things over here. And that will give me more of a visual reference, okay? So if you do not see that little hole, you can use your slice, and it will slice it out for you so that you can see the physical representation. Now these are, let's do 3 inches high. Well here, I'm gonna do this one 2 inches high, and I will do this one 3 inches high, just so that you guys can kind of see the difference in sizing. And we'll do this one 2.5. Now you do wanna be careful when you are sizing them because you see how your hole sizes accordingly. So I think this will be a good comparison to show you how those need to be handled. Now I am going to select all of these and I'm going to fill them in with the same color because I want to cut them all on the same mat. And I do need to make sure that I have two of each because of course I need a matching pair. And what you can do too is you can use your rotate. I just rotated 180 degrees, and that will fit them closer together and save some of your material. Now, to make these duplicates, I'm just using a copy and paste. Okay. Now, when I go to make it, it will arrange these for me. All right. So I'm going to hit cancel. And what I want to do is I want to attach these together. And that will keep them inverted the way they are to help save on that material. Now, when I go to make it, see how they're grouped together better? All right. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put these in different corners of my cutting mat because I'm going to cut each one out of a different scrap of leatherette that I have. All right. We'll leave the material size as 12 by 12. And what we'll do is we will just make sure that our scrap covers the area that our leatherette needs to cut out of. So I can choose continue. And we're going to, you know what, let's go ahead and use the air too. So you can cut this on, actually I've done it on the Cricut Joy and also on the Maker, but I do know that the Air 2 is more common, and I don't want to mislead anybody and make you think that you have to have a Maker to cut the faux leather. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go to Browse All Materials, and we do have a video coming on setting up your own custom settings, but I'm going to give you a little preview here. Click Material Settings. What I want to do is scroll all the way down, and at the bottom, I can choose Add New Material. Now, I'm going to say Leatherette. Here, you know what? I will say Custom Leatherette and hit Save, and it's going to give me the option on how I want to cut this. Now, what I do leave it on the fine point blade. The leatherette that I cuts very well on this setting. Now, if depending on where you buy it, because different manufacturers of leatherette will have different settings, okay? Like there are some that you buy at your local craft store that's more of like a marine grade vinyl or upholstery vinyl. Those may be a little thicker. But if you're buying leatherette, from a vendor, they're usually online, and they're advertising to be cut with the Cricut, or even the Silhouette, or just, you know, a regular cutting machine, usually these cut settings will work well for you. But it is important that you test a small area first. That way it'll help you save some of your material, because patterned leatherette isn't, it's not a cheap material, just to be real with you. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to crank this all the way up. And if it was a particularly difficult cut, then I could also increase the number of passes. I don't need that. I just go all the way up and I hit save. And right here is my custom leatherette setting. All right. So now if I exit out, it's going to load that. I'm going to go back to browse all materials. And if I just type in custom, it will actually bring up all of my custom settings that I have. In this case, I'm back down to just one custom leatherette. That's fine. I'm going to hit done and it will save that for me. Now, I do change the pressure to more because it is a thicker material, but that's all I have to do. I set that custom setting, which is basically taking my blade all the way up, and I change the pressure to more. So now let's head over to the Cricut Explore Air 2, and I will show you about loading the leatherette and running it through your machine and how easy it is.
All right, guys, so here's what we have. We have our Explore Air 2. These are the scraps of leatherette that I have. They're really gorgeous patterns. I love them a lot. I have my mat, I have my J wires, and my trusty little jewelry pliers. Okay. Like them a lot. And then this is what I consider my secret weapon. I use this for a lot of crafting. It is a temporary repositionable adhesive, and I do use it with my leatherette. And that's why I have this sheet of paper right here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this over. Normally I would not do this in my work area, but I just want you guys to see here. All right. Think smarter, Becky. Smarter. Let's move your machine a little bit out of the way. Now, I'll say this. I used to spray directly on my mat, but sometimes that can gum up the mat. Now, if you do not have a repositionable adhesive spray, that is okay. All right. What that means is that you just need a really sticky mat. This is standard grip, but you may want to consider getting one of the strong grip mats. Okay. So the adhesive just helps to hold the leatherette in place. Now, some people like to put their leatherette face down. Normally I would, but I don't want to spray my adhesive onto the pattern side of the leatherette. So this is what we have. I did check. It corresponds with our cut files that we have in the software. This is probably my favorite part. It's hitting the open button. So I'm going to line this guy up, load,
No. I'm going to unload. It did not load correctly. And now, just hit cut. Now, I say that because I had this set to custom. Okay, now that's very important on an Explorer Air 2. You want that set to custom. Also, before I forget to tell you, I was saying if you do not have the repositionable spray, you can use a strong grip mat. You can also use painter's tape or masking tape to tape the edges around your leatherette to also help hold it in place. But I want you guys to see that is how cleanly of a cut that you get with leatherette. So this whole time, if you've been shying away from using leatherette, this is what you've been missing. Super cute. Now, I will say I cut these in multiple sizes for you guys to see. And I would keep these, okay? Because you can always put these on like a barrette or something like that, or even just an embellishment. Okay, these are my 2-inch teardrops. These are 2.5-inch rectangles. So here we are from largest to smallest. So to be honest with you, these are a little large for my taste, but hey, if they do it for you, you know, if you like it, I love it. That's what I got to say. Now, let's get our J-wires out. And I love these because they are so super easy. Also, keep an eye on your little circles. Sometimes they don't punch out. They do cut well. You just have to pull them out with your fingers. No big deal. Sometimes they'll also stick to your mat. And any of the above is fine. If your circles don't cut well, that's okay too, because you can actually punch holes with some fine tip tweezers or anything like that. All right, so let's separate out. You just need two individual earrings per pair is what I was trying to say. And these are the easiest things. All right, let me show you how easy this is, okay? You're gonna take the backing part and you actually thread it through, kind of like you would it through your ear. Pull this down, and then you can squeeze it shut. You can usually use your fingertips also, but you just want to give it a little squeeze. You don't want to stop it from dangling, okay? But give it a little squeeze, that way it doesn't fall off. Now, some people, they only have, especially seasonal earrings, they may not squeeze this part shut, so that they can have more of a single-use earring. And the point of that is so that you can save your J-wires, although they're not very expensive, but you can save your J-wires and just switch out your leatherette pieces. So remember we talked about sizing and the effect that it has on the hole that is cut. All three of these sizes worked very well for the J-wire because the J-wires are so thin. And literally, in that small amount of time, you have three completely different individual pair of leatherette earrings.
Okay, guys, so how did you feel about making our own leatherette earrings? Now, like I said, this is a really great introductory project to working with faux leather, which is also referred to as leatherette. And it's just really simple and easy. You guys saw how awesome your Cricut will cut through this stuff. And I mean, these take so little time and so little effort. Other than a little bit of assembly, they really kind of make themselves. So hopefully you enjoyed our project today. If you have any questions or comments, please definitely leave those down in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you guys, as well as any video requests, right? And of course, in exchange, I'm going to ask you to do that quick subscribe and share. Guys, I really, really love bringing you these videos, and that is what keeps our little channel going. So I'm going to wrap it up, but again, sincerely, thank you. I really appreciate it every time you stop by. And guys, we will see you next time.